Welcome, or welcome back to the classroom if you've been here before. Today I want to talk about transitions inside of DaVinci Resolve, how you can use them, some of the problems that you might run into, how you can modify them and save them as a preset. So let's take a look at our effects library, and if you don't see that, go to the top left of your screen where it says effects and then just click on that. This will open up the effects library. Open a drop down on toolbox and you will see video transitions. So these are the pre-built transitions that are implemented in DaVinci Resolve in the free version and the studio version. So we got a bunch of different dissolves here, additive dissolve, blur dissolve, and if you hover over them with your mouse from left to right, you can actually get a preview of what the transition is gonna look like. So we got a cross dissolve. This is probably one of the most common used transitions, and dip to color, non-additive, smooth cut. We also get a bunch of iris transitions. So these are basically just different shapes, a cross, a diamond, eye iris, and we got some motion transitions, a barn door, a push, a slide, split, and we got different shapes, box, heart, star, triangle, whatever. And then we got different wipes. So a band wipe, a center wipe, a clock wipe, and whatever. And then if you scroll a little bit down, you see fusion transitions. So you get brightness flash, camera shake, and whatever. There are a ton of different transitions implemented into Resolve. So how you would use them? First of all, we need two clips to put a transition in between to avoid the hard cut. So let's go to our media pool in the top left corner next to where it says effects library. Click on media pool and you see I got two different clips in here. I'm gonna highlight them and drag them on my timeline. Right now I have this drone shot and this one. And what I wanna do is I wanna transition from this one, from the first one to the second one. So let's close our media pool for now because we don't need that anymore. And let's now take a simple cross dissolve and put them over to our timeline above the space where we want the transition to happen. And as you can see right now, it just won't fit. You can try it one more time and let go of it and it just won't put the transition in between. And this is one of the problems that you might run into when you want to use a transition. So basically what a transition does is it lengthens the clip without showing it. So the transition actually has room to play. So let me show you this a little bit better. Right now, if I try to lengthen the clip, it says it's red. And basically, the red line here means that the clip is over, so it stopped recording at this point. And the same thing appears if I try to lengthen the beginning from the second clip. So basically, whatever Resolve does, it cannot lengthen the clip so that the transition actually has room to play. So what we have to do is we have to put an overlap, like something like this, so that the transition actually has some room to unfold. But right now we cannot implement a transition on here, right? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put them over and use my mouse cursor, go to the end of the first clip, click when I see this icon right here appear, click and then drag it something a little bit to the left, and then go to my second clip to the beginning because we want to trim the beginning, click on that and then drag it a little bit to the right. And as you can see, we got a white outline right now, and this is the actual length of the clip. So you get a visual representation of how long the clip's gonna be after you cut it. So let's go with something like this. And right now what I wanna do is I'm gonna move my second clip over to our first clip. And if I go to the transitions right now, and if I drag now a cross dissolve in between there, you can see that it shows up on our timeline. And if I'm gonna hit play right now, you can see that it smoothly dissolves into our second clip, just implemented our first transition. So what I'm gonna do next is, let's say I wanna customize this a little more. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna highlight my transition so that it gets outlined red. Then I'm gonna go to my inspector in the top right corner. And if it looks something like this for you, all you wanna do is just click on the inspector. And right now you have the transition inspector because we're working on a transition. First of all, we see a transition type and this is a cross dissolve because we used the cross dissolve from the effects library. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select cross dissolve, and there we can choose between a bunch of different transitions. So let's say we don't wanna use the cross dissolve, we wanna try another transition that we might like. We don't have to delete the cross dissolve from our timeline, we can actually just go to video transition type and then choose another one. Let's say I wanna use additive dissolve, and then I'm gonna hit play, and now we have an additive dissolve. Or let's say we wanna use an iris, so we can use an arrow iris, hit play, and right now we have a completely different transition, but we also have more customizability with those transitions. So let's stick to this arrow transition, and we have a lot of customizability. We can choose the duration in seconds or frames. If I click on here and then turn this to the right, you actually get a visual representation of how the transition's gonna lengthen in our timeline. So let's say I wanna make it really long, like 10 seconds. We can see that on our timeline. But let's say we wanna stick to 1 second. We also have the customizability of alignment. So we can align it to the end of the first clip. We can align it in the middle where the cut's gonna happen, or we can align it to the right. So basically set to the start of the second clip. But we also have a preset. Let's just put the alignment back to the middle. We have arrow up, we have arrow down, we have arrow left, and arrow right. So let's just stick with arrow down. And then we have an offset to center. So if I'm gonna drag this to the left, it will start the transition from the left. And then we can play with the aspect ratio. Let's just put the offset center and make it bigger or wider or a little more narrow and small. Let's stick to the default, and then we can rotate this. So let's say we don't want to use a preset, go down, left, up, right, whatever, we can rotate it. And then we have a lot more customizability over the rotation. And then of course we can add a border if that's what you're going for, or choose a different color for the border. Let's make this green because, you know, we're in the woods. Or let's say you don't want a border, but you want to feather the transition. Just select the feather, and then you have the border to feather it even more. Let's get rid of this and put some green border. And then we have the control over easing, which basically means that we can start the transition very slowly fading in, then the transition's happening, and then it slowly fades out. Because what's the point of using a smooth transition if the transition starts abrupt and ends abrupt, right? So let's go to ease in and out, and right now this is what it's gonna look. Perfect, this looks pretty good, but of course you can choose custom and do the custom transition curve yourself if you want that. But now, as we talked about lengthening our transition, we can also do this on the edit page. Let's go to our timeline, and if we hover over the end of our transition and click this, we can lengthen this and shorten this. So that's pretty neat. Let's say we want to stick to this. Let's say we want to have the transition a little bit more towards the second clip and a little less from the first clip. How would we do that? Because if I click this, it will shorten or lengthen every side together. But if I'm gonna hit the control key and do this, you can actually see that I can lengthen or shorten each side individually. So let's say I want to make it very long at the second clip and very short at the first clip, something like this. And let's say you're very happy with the transition that you just created, and you want to use that in multiple projects, but you don't want to go through each and every step of what I just did every time again. So what we could do is right click on that transition and create a transition preset. So let's just select that and just leave the name arrow iris preset, right? Then we want to hit OK. And now if I go to my effects library, in the video transitions, we have a dissolve, we have iris, we have motion, we have shape, we have wipe, and we have user transitions. So if I'm gonna delete this transition that I have on my timeline right now, I can just drag in my arrow iris preset, and it has the exact same parameters as I previously did. So this is a great time saver if you're gonna use a bunch of different transitions. You just have to do them one time, save them as a preset, and then use them from the user transition. But sadly, it doesn't save the custom length that we set. So when we want to have this starting very short but ending very long, we have to do that manually once again. But well, that's not very time consuming, so we can totally do that. So that's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I hope you learned something new. If so, please consider leaving a like, because that would just mean a ton to me. And yeah, that's all I gotta say. Hope you have a great day. See you in the next one. Bye.